I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Hey, pero, bon, bro, where's your car?
Fucked up.
Yeah, oh, but where's that?
The insurance? Like, we call the insurance in since it's not my fault. They're gonna fix it. If it's fixable, they're gonna fix it for free.
Oh, yours is fixable, isn't it?
Yeah. No. See, if it's not fixable, because I hit it pretty hard. I hit like the concrete.
So,
if
Jose, this was day one? All over?
Yeah, a couple more minutes just to loosen up.
How did it feel? Feel good? Feel at home?
Yeah, man. It's good to see so many young fighters. You know,
it's busy here.
Yeah. But we're gonna have our own session, you know, on a Palmer. But, so he's gonna bring the best out of me, you know what I mean, during those sessions. But it's good to be back, you know. I love the sport. I love, you know, feeling that impact in my body, you know, that vibration go through my body after every hit. You know, I'm excited, man. It's like a new chapter in the book. You know what I mean? And we're starting off, you know, the right way, because it's not like I'm coming off bad fights. You know what I mean? I feel like
you're in the right spot.
Better and
you're
better
the,
and
you're
now,
with the belt, WBC champion, undefeated. Yeah. You're very popular.
And now we have a young coach who's hungry, who loves the sport, who. He's very dedicated to it. That's also, you know, that also surrounds himself with a lot of good fighters.
Yeah, no, you're in a great camp.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we'll see. We're excited, like I said. Excited to learn something new, better my craft.
I think your fans are going to be very excited too. The people who follow you. Because nobody knows, by the time this video goes up, whenever we post it, people, the internet will go crazy.
Yeah.
All right, let's see your skills in the bag. Speed back. Can you do any tricks?
My
doing about, I don't know, 20 rounds, 18 rounds, and your hands are not tired, you're gonna...
Well, this is good conditioning, for your shoulders. If you keep the rotation short, it works best.
Who's your favorite fighter in history?
A lot of good fighters, like Chavez, Ricardo Benito Lopez,
now, Jose, you went to the Philippines to spar Manny Pacquiao. A, what was that like? And B, fighting Lucas Matisse. Break it down.
Yeah, it was going to be a good fight. You know, we'll see how much Pacquiao has left, how much he could take. I know Matisse is but what I hear, he's a hard hitter.
He is a hard hitter.
Pacquiao still has that beat. That speed, that confidence to probably be able to the punch and to break him down. But it'll be a tough fight for Pacquiao because he getting older and older, and I think Matisse is coming out becoming a world champion, and he feels hungry, you know? At the age that he's in, he's still hungry.
Do you remember sparring Manny in the Philippines?
Yeah.
What was that like?
Two-day round.
Wow. How hard does he hit?
It doesn't have.
Did you ever drop him?
Huh?
Did you ever drop him in sparring? Did you ever
drop him?
It was a good sparring. You don't want to say. You're keeping it classy.
The thing is that... I like the work, you know?
Yeah. He's a good dude.
Yeah. And he's, I don't like to spar guys and take them too lightly, you know? And he's the same way, he only knows one speed. And I ain't drop him. We got balls.
He kept coming and coming.
I landed some of his hard shots. You know, a lot of, then after the break, you know, for the hitting program. But he also has some good shots too. You know,
Is he the
fastest?
Is he the fastest guy you ever sparred? Or is someone faster?
Well, those young fighters are very, very, very fast, you know? But the thing is that they only go... I only go like 4 rounds and then we switch them up.
Yeah, but him...
You know, but he's consistent, you know, with the speed drop. Because we went up to 10 rounds one time.
Okay, who's faster, him or Linares?
Linares is very equal, actually.
Okay, who
is... I think Tyson's footwork is a little faster, you know? So that helps him a lot, but that's just hands. They're about the same.
Who is harder, Pacquiao or Linares?
Pacquiao.
Pacquiao is harder?
Yeah.
Who has better defense?
I learned about the same on both sides.
Okay.
But, Pacquiao, sometimes he gets a little carried away with the speed and picks up his speed sometimes, you know? Linares is more... Tom, you know, but he's also doesn't have the force, you know?
The reason I'm asking all these comparisons is because there's a lot of talk of Lomachenko Pacquiao. So yeah, let's see what Lomachenko does with Linares Saturday, and then let's see what Lomachenko does with Pacquiao.
It's open up for Pacquiao to fight me too.
Really?
Yeah, but he decided to go to Batista fight. Right before this fight. About a month ago. After I became a world champion.
Yeah. Who, you and Linares?
Me and Pacquiao.
You're about, who did Pacquiao fight?
Well, he's gonna fight on Batista.
Oh, got it. So it was supposed to be you. Would you like that fight? You sparred in 58 rounds, you know it. That's a lot of rounds. That would be sick.
Like I said, I have a mentor. We gotta focus on him, you know?
Yep, we just program.
Yeah.
And he means business.
Yeah. I'm excited, you know? The person was supposed to be on Friday, and I got postponed for today, but I haven't heard anything.
Would you like to fight Crawford one day?
Crawford?
He's a champion, one of the best pop-up phones.
No, he's a good fighter.
Great fighter.
I see him fight. Very good fighter. Yeah, I respect him as a champion, you know, but I'm not afraid of normal. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I know.
Let's see. My job is to stay focused and get myself ready to whoever's...
Absolutely, you're right. Whoever's in front of you. That's
and,
true.
Any other opinions out there? Especially fans, sometimes they take certain things in a different way. Change it up and take it out of context. And
that's true.
Stuff like that, but... I respect every world champion and every guy who's, you know... Gets to fight for a world champion. And but inside, you know, we all mean business, you know. We I try not to fight the best, and And there's no one that can tell me that I'm not ready to fight the best, you know?
No, you did something that very few fighters do, win a championship, yeah. And you're undefeated.
Yeah. And you're very fortunate for both my team, for myself, you know, with the dedication that I put in. I started boxing when I was 8, you know? I thought almost won an amateur fight.
That's crazy.
I won 180-something fights. I follow Macheco in the amateurs.
You follow Macheco in the amateurs?
Yeah, I was 18, he was 23, I believe.
What weight guys? What weight?
132.
How was that? Where was that? Was that an Olympics or World?
World Championship.
How was the fight? Did you know him?
I know who he was.
Okay, so he gets in the ring, you get in the ring. What did you see?
He was an Olympic gold medalist already. Okay. It was the 2011, right before the... It was for the qualifiers for the 2012 London Olympics.
His sparring partners tell me that when you spar him, he has 6 hands and 3 Lomachenkos in the ring. Was it like that when you fought him? Was it 3 of them or?
Yeah, it was competitive. You know, he had good angles. He has this breaking out the waist, you know, with a very tight defense. I really didn't know who he was. And I was just an 8-year-old trying to become an Olympian myself. You know, and I didn't care. You know, nobody told me. No one told me that I wasn't ready for that kid. You know, I made it to the World Championships just because I was ready. And now, you know, now we get to the pros. And now people want to say if you're ready or not. You know what I mean?
Well, listen, he's moving up to 35. Yeah. He may move up to 40. If you're still at 40, it's a very possible fight because you're the champion. Would you want to fight him again in the pros?
Oh, yeah, I would love to fight him on the second one. Macheco looks like for one day. I'd like to fight.
The best of the best. Pound for pound kings. Yep.
You know, I'll wait till anything happens in the sport of boxing, so I gotta stay focused on what's going on.
You're absolutely right. Well, right now, Crawford's at 47 and Lomachenko's at 35.
They're not in my mind. But if you ask me, you know, if I take a second to think about it, you know, then. I would definitely would like to face those type of fighters.
All right, so one question. When you fought Lomachenko, what's the one thing that surprised you the most? Because obviously he's one of the best in the world.
He has a good little angle step. You know, he doesn't exaggerate on his movement. Yeah. They're just so...
His pivots are...
His pivots and he takes that, you know, stays away from being in the middle. And it really allows him to throw good punches towards the... So when you're not seeing him, right?
Yeah.
He lands pretty, very clever. He lands pretty solid.
He's accurate. Maybe
doesn't look like he's throwing a lot, but he, you know, those little snaps, those little solid punches right to the, you know, if you're not blocking them, you know, little by little, they'll break you down.
Listen, he's made 4 people quit. It's not a mistake.
Yeah, that's what happens. I think, you know, listen, he's not throwing hard punches, but he's throwing those perfect short, you know, put your body behind him and. It doesn't look like he's trying, but he's no need to, you know? That's the fundamental of boxing. Very short, you know, short distance. Just those type of punches here, and he just...
No, I've seen him spar hundreds of rounds. He's amazing. But I will say this. You wanted to do 6 minutes, you're going on 14. You're killing it. But there you have it. Jose Ramirez, tell people where to follow you one more time.
JC Ramirez 2012. That's my Instagram account. On my Twitter.
J. Ramirez 2012.
JC
Ramirez. Mikey, nice hat today. Look at Mikey's hat.
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna go cage fighting now. Fuck boxing.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach. Take a step back.